Hello, my name is Fatma Hussein from Path Youth Organization. We will be having a discussion on child marriage as a way of celebrating the 16 days of activism against gender-based violence. With me here today are our panelists.
Mohammed Ali.
I'm Salim Ali.
And I'm Fatma Amani.
As stated earlier, our topic today will be on child marriage. So my number one question will be, what are the perspectives of child marriage according to our panelists here?
Being an African and what we've been hearing about Africa in relation to child marriage, it has been taken as it's more of a culture. But personally, relating on the question on my perspective, I believe it's more of inhuman, and I really disrecommend on any issues pertaining child marriage.
From my perspective is that child marriage is wrong, because if the child is still underage, so he or she has no, like, he or she cannot give consent to anything. So if at all he or she is getting into marriage, so it means it's a forced thing, and that's wrong.
Basically, child marriage is wrong.
Yeah.
So my question is, what are the drivers of child marriage?
I believe there are a number of drivers, but we cannot shy away from poverty, not only across Kenya, but generally Africa. Poverty has been a key issue, because most of our parents directly, in Africa, we are living under a $10 per day. So, and with the current economic situation and status, many parents are ready to marry off their children for the purpose of benefiting economically.
Another driver of actually child marriage, sometimes, yes, I'm of underage, but I really want to get married. So I'll say some children or some girls want to get married because of escape. They're either escaping from something, a problem at home, or a problem somewhere else. So escape is a driver of child marriage. Also, having a feeling that the fact that the state is not now putting into consideration, or rather putting into action, the implementation of laws. There are a lot of laws for child marriages and child rights and human rights and everything. But the fact that there are just low implementations of these now laws, I think is and should be a driver of child marriage. Like, I'm getting my child married because I know that they can't do anything. The law cannot stand up for what is wrong.
I feel basically adding on her point, the law enforcing system is really letting us down. With the few cases around Coast Region, basically which are coming out of the early pregnancies, the law enforcers, maybe to be specifically, the disease starts from a police station, where maybe a report is done. Either it's a early pregnancy or it's through defilement cases. Mm-hmm. So at the police station, most of the time, if either of these two families never agree on compensating the girl, and it will mean now the case that it will proceed. But at any given point, if they agree at the level of police station, that means they'll move out free. So already at the police station, there is a failure of the system that it creates, or it showcases the community, to the community also there, that if at any given point someone got pregnant, or it is a matter of defilement, maybe it's a cross defilement between underages, if the families can agree, then these kids can be married, which I feel it's a really big trigger for child marriage. And again, our judicial system, I really appreciate whatever Mr. Maraga, he has done a lot, towards ensuring that the justice is accessed timely and promptly. But again, we know very well in our judicial systems there is a lot of backlog. So when it is a matter of children, we know that there is there should be an enforcement of fast tracking these matters. But in most of the scenarios, you'll see cases dragging for more than 5 years. So this kid, first of all, is pregnant. She's already a baby and gets another baby. So at the end of the day, the culprit will not be sent to jail or behind bars. Mm-hmm. But again, now they'll sit down, as in we get to understand each other, and at the end of the day, they'll get married.
Mm-hmm. According to Salim, also, it's kind of common for, according to him, it's common for also boys to be engaged in child marriage. But in my perspective, I think it's not very common for boys as compared to girls. So why do we think that the girls are more at risk of engaging in child marriage than the men?
Okay, from my perspective, ni kuwa, you know, a girl, a woman, ni mtu mwenye, so according to me, it's so easy to manipulate. Mm-hmm. You get so ku manipulate a girl ni rahisi kuliko ku manipulate a boy. So no wonder kuna a lot of child marriage cases kwa girls kuliko kwa boys. Then the drivers zenye to list to, most of them zina affect girls. Mm-hmm. Naelewa, and boys.
So we can add manipulation as one of the drivers.
Yeah, because let's say mtoto amekuja, like a girl from a family, anambiwa kuwa is this man, ye bado ako, let's say 16, 17. Mm-hmm. Then anambiwa is this man, ako mm-hmm. ready kuchukua, like kukumari, mm-hmm. then ako na pesa, all of that. So ye akiona, like mzazi amesema, so ye ako ready kuenda. Ama kisia kuna pesa, mm-hmm. ako ready kuenda. Yeah. So the manipulation out of the money, manipulation out of the parents' advices, inampelekea yeye akue kwa marriage.
Okay, from this discussion, I'm seeing that you are basing so much on the girl child. What about this boy who gets married at the age of 17?
Okay, I think it's more or less the same. Mm-hmm. Like if a boy gets into marriage at a tender age, mm-hmm. he'll drop out, and his decision-making powers ndani ya marriage itakuwa kidogo. So it means atakuwa imposed vitu zenye afai kufanya. You get? There are some things zenye atakuwa normal marriage, mtu anakuwa imposed, like anakuwa imposed na anakuwa forced kufanya. You get? Mm-hmm. So let's imagine a boy, a 19-year boy getting mm-hmm. to child marriage. So it means the things to ni same according to me.
Okay, Mohammed here said a point about a young boy impregnating a young girl. Mm-hmm. They are both children, yeah, by law. So, and they are forced to marry each other.
Yeah.
What are the effects in that marriage? To the girl and to the boy?
I'd say that the first effect that is likely, mm-hmm. most likely in fact, to appear in that marriage will be self-harm.
Mm-hmm.
Because I think there's nothing more serious than like messing with a boy's ego, rather.
Mm-hmm.
So let's say this 14-year-old boy mm-hmm. now gets a 13-year-old pregnant,
mm-hmm.
and this is a boy who has no job.
Mm-hmm.
He's actually depending on the parents for support and school and stuff. So self-harm is likely to come in because he's going to think of the shame first he's brought, and then tuseme imejulikana it's this 14-year-old with this 13-year-old, and then the 13-year-old parents want the girl to just stay with the boy. Huyu ni kijana ambaye hana jinsi, tukumbuke.
Mm-hmm.
So,
hana means.
He's 14. So, he's likely going to, like, anakana yo shame, mpaka mm-hmm. to the point of self-harm. So, siheri tu ni jiwe kitu ishe.
Then we nowadays we talk about the issues of parenthood. On my perspective on particular that question,
mm-hmm.
wazazi wa siku hizi utasikia wazazi hawana maadili. But where does it start? I feel your question is where this problem starts.
Yeah.
Both of them, they are underage. So the type of life they'll be living, it's like we don't care. Whatever comes through, we go with it through. So at the end of the day, it has a ripple effect on day-to-day lives. That's when tukipita mitani unasikia, watoto asiki, sijui watu. But it trickles down to the foundation of the parents, because these parents were not prepared psychologically to be parents.
Well, many of us here have interacted with various NGOs in Mombasa, in the coast. So what do we think are the efforts that have been made to change this issue of child marriage?
Okay, personally, you can see the government has done a lot. And not only the government, but also international agencies, international organizations. Mm-hmm. Like we had an African Charter on the Rights and Welfare of Children, mm-hmm. where the child, there was a stipulated age mm-hmm. for someone to get married, that mm-hmm. was 18.
Okay.
And it also listed the rights that are entitled to a child, and it also enlisted that the laws that are enforced to someone who gets into child marriage.
Mm-hmm.
So personally, I think the government alone has done a lot, and the government has signed many conventions, many charters, and many unions that are gearing towards against child marriage. And I can also say at the coast region, we have some organizations. Let's say Path Youth Organization
mm-hmm.
is also one of the organization which is more or less focused with the child marriage. Because if Path Youth Organization is focused on education, mm-hmm. it means it's focusing on creating awareness against child marriage.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So I understand what you're saying. There are various organizations who are doing that, the government is doing that, but still these things keep going on. So these marriages, where do they take place? Because they happen, they still happen,
mm-hmm.
and the government is there, the civil society organizations are there. So what's the problem, Dodo? Because these marriages are still going on.
Firstly, I'll enjoin my colleague here on the efforts done.
Mm-hmm.
But my problem with these efforts done, decisions are made on round tables, on conferences.
Mm-hmm.
But the agreements done in these big and posh hotels
mm-hmm.
are not reaching the local mwananchi. I feel we have very good policies. We have very good activists,
mm-hmm.
but these activists, most of them, or even our government agencies which are working against child marriages,
mm-hmm.
They are more likely into urban setups.
Mm-hmm.
And this, apart that even in urban setups, these issues are coming up, but the rural setups, there are more of these issues than the urban
mm-hmm.
setups.
Mm-hmm.
Most of the funded projects on the issue you're talking about, they are captured within urban centers only. I guess that's where the problem is.
Mm-hmm.
In conclusion, our Sexual Offence Act in the 2010 Constitution, it's so strong that if it could be followed an act to the other,
mm-hmm.
it could be very effective. But we have a very good act against this, but it is never implemented.
Mm-hmm. So what are our recommendations on the way forward? What should be done to curb this challenge?
I can say there should be on the side of law enforcement,
mm-hmm.
okay, we have the rules, we have the laws.
Mm-hmm.
So we should have, social accountability. like we hold the people responsible or the officers responsible accountable.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we have this law,
mm-hmm.
and maybe the case imepitia kwa chief. But chief akainyamazia tu ile case pale nyumbani. So sisi kama the community, we should hold this chief accountable. Like mbona huyu na huyu imetokea hivi na why mbona ijeendelea mbele. That's my perspective. That's my recommendation. Then the other thing, for the CSOs, the NGOs, and every entity enye iko related or concerned, I just urge them to be so strong and so willing for the work against child marriage. Yeah.
Maybe my way forward, ningependelea kwamba when these agencies, either governmental or non-governmental, are talking about activism against child marriage and other rights of the child, watu waifanye na roho ya ukweli. You know, people are into these things because of they're looking at self-benefit. First of all, it comes first it's me, then yenye tabaki ndo na yule mwingine. So I feel first the focus should be on that kid,
mm-hmm.
and then ripples back now to you. We understand people need to live,
mm-hmm.
but we live rightfully.
So I'm thinking that the problem, charity begins at home. So for me personally, I recommend that kuwekwe like strong communication channels, especially between parents na watoto wao. If I don't want something, I just don't want it. See, ati na lazimisho by my parents, especially these things happen by iyo nguvu ya wazazi. If the parents don't want, then mtoto hawezi olewa. Now, if the parents understand that I do not want, then they can't force me into getting into something I don't want. So the first recommendation is that communication channels equal very strong. And then the other one is in terms of law regulations. I mean, these things are just so open. Like, it's there, they see it. The one that signs the marriage certificate sees that this is an underage child. So I think that, yes, he talked of the royal ukweli thing. And I'm thinking that I think the government should instead implement the thought of employing people based on, you know, their liking of something, not just papers but skills. Can I hold this person accountable? I think they should base more on integrity of a person rather than just the papers and the skills. And then the other thing that I think should really work is a support system, a good support system. Yes, it could be that at home things are not very well and that you're being forced to get married, but these are things that neighbors see, the community see. So I think that support is very important in that as a neighbor, seeing a young child getting married, now being forced into getting married, I think it's my responsibility to come out and support the kid. Do you want this? Is it going to work for you? And how can I help into now out-countering this? So support is important. See, ati kitu may happen and then ndio mtu anakuja baadaye and saying, oh, she told me, aliniambia, but she did nothing. So I think a strong support system should be really reliable, is really reliable.
Okay, as part of the conclusion, mimi naona as my recommendation ni kuwa hii kitu inafaa ikuwe a collective sort of, yani kila mtu achukue jukumu ku end such a thing, kwa sababu as from the discussion tumeona kuwa child marriage basically ni mbaya, so we should change it either as civil society organizations ama hata sisi wanajamii kule chini. If we have means we end, then we should do it together.
Okay, we've had a successful discussion. Thank you, our panelists, and for the viewers out there, you can join us in the discussion on the comment section. Thank you.